Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are very, very fine. Today, we are going to discuss chapter 16, that is famous authors and their books. Okay? Today, we are going to know many books which has been written by the Indian authors. Authors not only inspire the generation, but they also enhance the way of writing and way of thinking of all the people. Okay, they inspired the generation by their work and the thought which is written inside the book. In India, many authors has been there who has written so many books, and by that book they have spread so many nice things, nice thought to the generation, and inspired and had inspired to do the nice work for their society as well. Okay, today we are going to discuss many of the authors. So here I will give you more than one example of the books which has been written by the same author, and some question will be also asked on the basis of that. So it's a request, don't skip the video and be with the video till the last, and please note down the other example of written book by the same author. So without any delay, let's start our video. First, we are going to discuss about the Rabindranath Tagore. He was the great author. Okay, he has also got so many awards and Nobel Prize for the remarkable work for Gitanjali. He was born in 1861 and at the age of 80, he died in 1941. Okay, in Gitanjali, he has written 157 poems. Okay. Initially, it was written in the Bengali, but later on, as it was very remarkable, so it was translated in the other languages also. The other book written by the Rabindranath Tagore is Fireflies, The Post Office, and Kabuliwala. Some are the stories, some are the poems, some are the songs. Kabuliwala is very nice book in which the story has been discussed about the chickpeas vendor who went to the street and he connected with a small younger girl. Okay, and the story is based on that vendor and that young girl. So this is very fascinating. This is very nice story which can be read by the small children also, and it can also be read by the elder one also. Okay, to enjoy or to pass the nice thought to their children. Second is R.K. Narayan, who was born on 10th of October 1906 and died at 13th May 2001. He has written The Malgudi Days, which was based on the small towns and the cities of the South India. In this stories, the small stories, you can you can be familiar with the culture and tradition of the South India. With the small stories, they had tried to convey the rules and regulation of the societies. These are very, very attractive story, not very much. They has been divided into so many small parts which can be easily read. Okay, and in this way you can enjoy, and as well as you can learn so many nice thing which is related to the South India and also related to the society. It is they are dealing the fact related to our society. The other book which is written by the R.K. Narayan is The Vendor of Sweets and The English Teacher. The Guide, which is a very, very nice novel, is also written by R.K. Narayan. Next is Ruskin Bond. Okay, he is also an Indian author who was born in 1934. Okay, he has received so many awards like Sahitya Academy Award, Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, and so on. Okay, he has written The Blue Umbrella, in which the story, in which the young girl, which was whose name was Binya, okay, the character name was Binya, and he was so attracted towards the blue umbrella, which was owned by the Japanese tourist. Okay, and she was very fascinated with this umbrella, and she has exchanged this umbrella, we can say. She has exchanged this umbrella by giving her necklace to that Japanese tourist. Okay, so this story is about the Bindya. This is a very good story. Okay, I must suggest to read this story. Next is A Flight of Pigeon, which is also written by the Ruskin Bond, and Our Tree Still Grow in the Dehra is also written by the Ruskin Bond. Next is very very famous, you must know, the Sunil Gavaskar. The complete name of Sunil Gavaskar is Sunil Manohar Gavaskar. He is not only an author, but he is also a great cricketer. Okay, he is the first cricket player to make over 10,000 runs. Okay, so he has done a remarkable work in his in his career. Okay, his autobiography is A Sunny Day. In this book he has written all the experiences and all the challenges what he faced before becoming a cricketer. Okay, he has discussed his life in this book. The other book which is written by Sunil Gavaskar is A Straight Drive, and one is One Day Wonders. In One Day Wonder, it is discussed about the World Cup which was held in 1985 in the Australia. He has discussed all the journey from the India to the Australia and all the experiences too about that World Cup. Okay, so if you are interested in cricket, okay, you can read this book. It is a very nice book. Next is Dr. Salim Ali, who is also known as Birdman of India. He was born in 1896 and died at 1987. One movie has also been there. You can watch that movie, which is based on Dr. Salim Ali. The name is Robot 2.0, in which Akshay Kumar has performed a very nice work. Okay, he has discussed some part of the life of Dr. Salim Ali. Okay, the book which has been written by the Salim Ali is totally based on the birds. He was the bird lover. Okay, he has done so many work for the birds. Okay, he has also tried to save the species of the bird. In whole year he has done only the social work related to the bird. Okay, and that only you can see in the movie. The Salim Ali has also written The Fall of a Sparrow and The Birds of Kerala. As you can see, he has only discussed about the bird. Next is Vikram Seth. He is an Indian author and a poet also. He was born in Kolkata on 28th June 1952. Okay, he has written A Suitable Boy, which was published in 1993. In this book, it has been discussed about the four families. Okay, the next book is written by the Vikram Seth is An Equal Music and The Golden Gate. The Golden Gate is also one of the famous book written by the Vikram Seth. Next is Khushwant Singh. He was not only the author, but he was also the lawyer and the politician. He was born in 1915 and died in 2014. He has experienced a lot of things before the independent and after the partition of India. You all are knowing that India got partition by the name of India and Pakistan. So he has written Train to Pakistan. In this book, he has written all the facts related to the partition and the way of the passenger who is going to the Pakistan. It is totally inspired by the partition of the India and Pakistan, which is based on the fact stories. It is based on the fact. Okay, which deals all the situation and the difficulties, how they were feeling, all the feelings when they were going to the Pakistan and leaving the India. Okay, this is very nice book. Okay, when you will grow up and you will come to know a lot of things about the independence of India, you can go through this book. Sunset Club is also written by the Khushwant Singh, and The Land of Five Rivers is also authored by the Khushwant Singh. The next is Vishnu Sharma. Whenever we listen this name, only and only one image comes in our mind, that is the story which is completely made with the help of the animals. Okay, Panchtantra. Panchtantra is very, very attractive folk tales and fables stories. They are the imaginary stories which were very nicely framed, and they were conveying the social, social moral values. Okay, all the characters are animal in this, and initially it was written in the Sanskrit before 25 years ago. Okay, later on these story was so nice and fascinating, they were converted in Hindi or English also. So this is very nice. We have also watched this, and I also suggest you to please see and read the stories of the Panchtantra. They are very, very fascinating. Next is Anil Padmanabhan, who has written the Kalpana Chawla. Kalpana Chawla, you all are knowing, was the great astronaut. Okay, she was the first female astronaut to go in the space. Okay, and you all are knowing, in this book he has mentioned all the situation to become an astronaut. Why? Because the Kalpana Chawla belongs to the middle class family, and to become an astronaut, what a difficulty she has faced and how she has achieved that position, all things are written in this in a detailed way. Okay, next is Anita Desai. She is also known as Anita Majumdar, and she was born on 24th June 1937. Whenever you will see the cover of the book, all the book of Anita Desai, then they are related to the society. They are so attractive, and they are always dealing the situation or the problems related to the society. Fasting and feasting. Okay, in this the character are Uma and Aruna. This is the story of two sisters who are taught all the household activities. Okay, they are trained in the traditionally feminine skill. Their mother used to train them. Okay, all the work which is done by all the females in the home. Okay, traditionally. So this is also based on the social values, I guess. So if you are interested, you are a social person, then you can go through this novel. Next is Diamond Dust, and Games at Twilight is also written by the Anita Desai. Next is Susanna Arundhati Roy, who was born on 24th November 1961. Okay, the God of Small Thing. In this book, the story is of the twins, okay, who has to face so many problems. How to love, who to love. There were so law, rules and regulation, okay, to show the love. In this book also, the things are related to the society. It is completely based on the fact which we generally face in our society. The another book is War Talk and the Azadi. The last author is the Chetan Bhagat. Okay, he is very, very famous, who was born on 22nd of April 1974, and he is an IITian. He has completed his IIT from the Delhi, and then after he has also completed his MBA from the IIM Ahmedabad. So he is very educated as well. Okay, and he has written so many books. Okay, one of them is One Indian Girl, Two States, and The Three Mistakes of My Life. Okay, in this Three Mistakes of My Life, there are three friends. Okay, the story is about three friends who started their work and has done the major mistake. All that mistake has been discussed in this book, and to know the mistake, you have to read this book. Okay, the next is The Girl in Room 105, and the next is one more book is there, which I am not showing, The Half Girlfriend. Okay, this book only is given in your book, so you can find from there. So these all are about the author and the books. Okay, mostly you have to learn book authors and the name of the book. Okay, don't go with the when the author was born and so on. Only focus how many books they have written and the little bit which I have discussed in this video. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I hope this video will help you to learn the name of more book, okay, which has not been given in the book. Thank you so much.